probably started working on it about 4 or 5 years ago. I remember, I think, telling Mei Ann about it ages ago, and she actually managed to watch a reading of it at the LARC in New York. And we've been looking for a project to work together on. So I approached Mei Ann and she was very excited. And Mei Ann is also an amazing dramaturg, so she's got a really good eye for, you know. So I don't know if I sent, I think I sent you the play before, actually, several versions of it, I think, along the way, and she's given me feedback. But looking for a platform in which, because she's based in the US, so looking for a platform in which we could devise this or bring it to the next level together, or at least just try it out. And I think so that's where you know, I approached Center 42 about the guest room scheme and the different, you know, I think it was guest room or basement workshop. And I think at that stage we decided, okay, we'll try for the guest rooms scheme. And so I brought Mei Ann back for that, and then we got together this amazing team of actors.
I can't emphasize how necessary that week was in terms of developing, because I'm one of those directors, like, I don't know until it's up on its feet. So like I can give some dramaturgy notes and I can read it and whatever, but the minute the actors start to bring it to life, as you know as theater makers, it just expands everything a thousandfold, and you really start to get all of the different layers and start to negotiate all of those layers and what's happening. And we also needed a way forward, so we did a lot of improvisation in terms of what are these puppets? Mm. How do you move? What it is. So it wasn't just script work, it was also a lot of on your feet. What is a puppet? What does it mean to create? What does it mean to write at all? All of those things came to life. Without that week of experimentation and innovation and deep, deep investigation into what this play is about. And Jean was very generous because we had sessions where we would have this board and we would break apart exactly what it was. And I asked the actors these questions. I said, why are stories important? Why are new stories important? What do you want them to walk out going, oh, that's what I've gained from that? And people said incredible things that actually made it into the play.
It got cut. The latest redraft, I lost 40% of my script. So, I lost 20, I cut 20 pages of a 50-page script.
Dramaturgy was done by everyone, right? Like, the actors were incredibly vocal. They had a lot of investment in their characters and what was going on. They really, like, could identify when something was repeating, that they were saying the same thing, that they were like, wait, but what's happening here? So they were so generous with their contributions to the structure itself.
The importance of that collaboration, because really in that room, that play was completely torn apart and people helped me piece it back together again. I couldn't have done it on my own. I think there was a limit, and I think that's why I felt so frustrated, because there was a limit to how much I could work on my own with the text. Just having text, just, it wasn't enough. Really made it very, very rigorous, sometimes painful, but extremely rigorous process of refining and purifying and pulling out exactly what is the story we want to tell then.
Art making is not efficient, but the key thing is not about efficiency, but essential activity towards finding more complex truth together. But this should not be painless. If it's painless, then you're not asking the right questions.